if you can hear me because the camera's like super far, but it's a very beautiful 65 degrees in Boise right now. I leave for San Antonio tomorrow.
Right there. That's where I did all the PT. Lots of literal blood, sweat, and tears on that.
Yeah.
There's home right there, baby.
It's a very beautiful day outside here at Lackland. Don't know what the weather is, but it's just nice. Slight breeze. Today is Tuesday. I'm gonna go out, get some lunch, and then get some running shoes, probably take a nap if I have time. So, today I drove past my old squadron, which was the 331st Training Squadron. Wolf Pack, that's what I went through. Oh, it was so good to pass by my old home. Actually, I did the calculating in a calendar, and 3 years ago, I was in the fourth or fifth week of training. I remember that, just halfway through it. Military, but I just have to respond in kindness and empathy. And I'm only halfway through. I think it's very obvious that I'm halfway done. But we'll see how the next 3 years go. We'll see what happens when I get back to mountain home after this. Fly fight. Did you hear that?
better. I know you feel worse. If nothing went numb, I think something would hurt. I'd seen this before, never thought you'd be hurt. You're young and you're precious. Your laugh is infectious. Your heart's big as Texas. Don't think you're reckless, but maybe you strayed from the cross on your necklace. And now I feel selfish, cause I miss my best friend. Still skipping breakfast and higher than Everest. Slowing down the time, you can say you're fine.
Okay, hello, welcome back to another episode of Cole.
Yeah.
It's been a long time since we did this. My review of the Blanco barbecue. Let's start off with the sides before we get into the main dish, because I have a lot of things I want to say about the main dish. I had the mac and cheese. The mac and cheese was just okay. It was cheesy. It was warm, but there was nothing special about it. So I give it a solid 3.2 out of 5. Next was the beans. Now the beans, I would say it was a little more special. They had a little bit of a kick to it. They also had some brisket inside of it, which was pretty good. So for the beans, I give it a solid 4.2 out of 5. Now let's get into the brisket. Now the brisket was fatty. It was good. It had some fat trims on the side of it, which is what I was looking for, because I really want that flavor. But I didn't think that it was seasoned or marinated before. So it was just the raw meat. Something that they do is they use good quality meat. I tried the brisket with their barbecue sauce. Their barbecue sauce had... it's very watery. It has a little bit of vinegar to it. It's got just a little bit of a kick. So I would dip the brisket in the barbecue sauce. It would give it a little extra flavor. It's pretty good. Finally, I recommend a rating of the brisket to be 4.2. I liked it. I didn't love it. Lastly, I want to talk about the ribs. I was told they would fall off. Did they fall off? They weren't quite as tender as I liked them to be. But they tasted good. They had fat on them. They were nice and thick. Something I want to say here is that I thought that this wasn't going to be enough food. Turns out that it's really filling. The ribs were really filling, and I am very satisfied with the meal. I didn't feel like it was too much food. I also wasn't hungry at the end. My final rating for Blanco Barbecue is a solid 4.5 stars out of 5. Now, why did I give it a 4.5 stars? Well, I did some research. This place is apparently... this place is apparently one of the best places for barbecue in San Antonio. Now, when I am eating at a place and they have such a high reputation, I do have higher expectations. Was it good? Yes, the food was good. It was very good. The biggest question here, would I come here again? The answer is yes. I would come here again. And that was it. I am done. It is Thursday. It is 3:14 p.m. And that's it. The TDY is complete. it's all good. I have my treatment plan. Now things are just gonna start. Things are gonna be quite official now.